हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे विल डिस्कस वुड्स रिएक्शन। वुड्स रिएक्शन इट इज द रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्काइल हैलाइड्स। इट इज द रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्काइल हैलाइड्स विद सोडियम इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राइथ। इट इज द रिएक्शन ऑफ अल्काइल हैलाइड्स विद सोडियम इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राइथ। Actually, this is a doubling reaction. Two alkyl halide molecules are used. As a result, alkane is formed. And this alkane is symmetrical alkane. Why? Because here both R group are same. For example, we have मिथाइल क्लोराइड हेयर वी हैव टू मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ मिथाइल क्लोराइड एंड टू सोडियम्स आर देयर इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई एथर इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ड्राई एथर इथेन इज फॉर्म। सो इट इज अ डबलिंग रिएक्शन। Two alkyl groups combine together to form alkane, and this alkane is a symmetrical alkane. Even number of alkanes are formed: ethane, butane, hexane, octane, and so on. So, first question is why triether is there? If any moisture content is there, then as we know, sodium is more reactive. So, here is a question. Why dry ether is used in a Wurtz reaction? If there is any moisture content, then sodium is more reactive. It will react with water to form sodium hydroxide plus hydrogen plus energy. So sodium will react with any moisture content to form a sodium hydroxide. Now this sodium hydroxide will react with the alkyl halide. It will be NSR reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction. OH ion will displace X. So we are going to prepare alkane, but unfortunately alcohol will form if there is any moisture content. That's why dry ether is used. Otherwise alcohol will be the major product instead of alkane, right? Now what is the mechanism of Wurtz reaction? Wurtz reaction proceed with the help of a free radical mechanism. As we know, there is one molecule Rx. This X is highly negative, so this will show partial negative charge, and alkyl group will show partial positive charge. As we know, there is sodium. It will lose its electron. As a result, it will lose its electron, and cation will form due to high electronegative nature of X. It will withdraw its electron from this bond. As a result, R will become deficient. Now this is deficient, so this electron is given to R. R capture this electron to form free radical. Now this sodium cation and X negative combines, so this is formation of a free radical. As we know, free radicals are highly reactive due to unpaired electrons. Another free radical will form by second molecule, so free radicals will combine to give alkane, right? From second molecule अगेन फ्री रेडिकल विल अराइज, बोथ फ्री रेडिकल विल कंबाइन, दे आर हाईली रिएक्टिव ड्यू टू अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स एंड अल्केन विल फॉर्म. सो दिस इज अ फ्री रेडिकल मैकेनिज्म ऑफ अ वर्थ रिएक्शन. देर इज अनदर वन मैकेनिज्म ऑल्सो. मैकेनिज्म नंबर टू, two alkyl halide molecules are there and two sodiums are there. Both these sodium lose one electron each, resulting into formation of a release of a two electrons. If we understand the bonding, this x is negative, this r is a positive, again this x is negative, this r is a positive. So these two electrons convert one carbocation to carbon ion. Here we have a partial positive charge. Now if it gain two electrons, then it will show negative charge, and hence from here we will get a R negative. These two sodium will combine with X, as a result 2NaX, two sodium halides are formed. Now this is R negative and here we have a R positive. One is carbon ion and second is carbon cation, so they will combine to form alkane. This is a second mechanism of this reaction. Actually the real mechanism is a free radical mechanism. Now what is the limitation of this reaction? Limitation number 1, by Wurtz reaction, methane can't be prepared, methane can't be formed. Why? Because if there is a at least one alkyl group, one carbon containing alkyl group there, then we will get a two carbon in a alkane. So methane can't be prepared by this method. Second, only symmetrical alkanes are prepared. Only symmetrical alkanes are prepared. Unsymmetrical alkanes can't be prepared by this method. If we use unsymmetrical alkyl groups, for example, we have Rx plus 2 sodium plus XR dash, then there is a mixture of alkane will form. R will combine with R itself to form R. And in similar manner, R dash molecule may combine with each other to form a. So now we have a mixture of alkanes, and due to comparable boiling point, it is not easy to separate them. They are having almost a comparable boiling point, so it will be very difficult to separate them. That is the limitation of Wurtz reaction. That's why it is preferred only to prepare symmetrical alkanes, right? So that's it for a Wurtz reaction. I hope you would understand it.